Hey guys, it's your boy, Ballface8020, back again with another great response video, or I guess more of a commentary. I want to start by saying that I do understand that a lot of times when I respond to people, my critiques can be pretty harsh. And you know, the way that I always try to justify it to myself is there's nothing mean-spirited about it. I'm never trying to hurt somebody or bring them down, even if it's somebody who I think like absolutely like nothing of, like just extremely little of, like Rollo or Casey. And it's true that I'm definitely never trying to bring anybody down or hurt anybody. I don't think I am either. But the thing is, I'm thinking about there's stuff that I've said about DBDR and stuff that I'm going to say about Chad Light in this video that if somebody had said about me, I wouldn't like it. So I'm not going to stop doing it because I like it. But maybe that's wrong of me. Maybe I should like be nicer. So there's two guys in the Black Pill content creation space whose opinion I really respect a lot, and that's New Poster and CBP. I don't know if CBP is still around. Now, when I say I respect their opinion, I mean on Black Pill related subjects. Like, you know, my understanding is that their politics are like very different than mine, like extremely different. I don't know if either of them are like Biden types, but they're definitely like will vote for Biden to stop Trump types. So they're not like the, they're not like the libs in my family who like actually like love Joe Biden, but they're still, you know, on that side. But on the, I'm talking about, like, when it comes to, like, those are two guys who, like, when they speak on a Black Pill subject, I'm going to listen. And but it doesn't mean I agree with everything they say. Because, I mean, I know I made that one response about, to New Poster regarding what he said about, you know, the whole hair loss thing. And I totally understood where he was coming from. I just had a very different perspective. And this is one where I think he's actually like wrong, like just like misunderstood somebody else. Like, Chad Light has this video where he's talking about him sleeping with some girl who had rejected him when he was younger. And I had meant to watch it last night, but it's like 20 some minutes long, and I really wanted to go and make that video that I ended up making last night, and I knew, I was like, I just want to go make the video now, and then, you know, I'll watch this video later, and end up watching it today. And, but before I'd even got a chance to watch it, New Poster made a comment on the video, the video I made last night, talking about how he doesn't like Chad Light, he's entitled, or stuff like that, like blah, 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 this stuff about, and he cited this video that I'm about to talk about, this video where Chad Light sleeps with a girl who had rejected him, like, years earlier, and New Poster's reaction to him was that he was extremely entitled, this is an extremely entitled person, Chad Light is, and that he was tried, you know, did this whole thing to like get revenge on this girl who had rejected him. And I watched the video and I was expecting that to be it, and that's not how I interpreted it at all. So here's the story of the video. You guys can, if you're interested, spoilers, so go watch it. Chad Light, as 18 or 19 year old, I presume, in some college, it's undisclosed college in an undisclosed city in an undisclosed state, is sitting next to some girl in some elective class. He is completely, this was back in 2012, at this time, the black pill didn't even really exist, so you can give him a bit of a pass. Not really. Not really, because this should be common sense. And the fact that it's not common sense explains, it's like, why women sometimes react the way they do. So he's, according to him, he's ugly at this time. Well, I don't know if he's ugly objectively, but what I do know is that he's objectively extremely fat in the range between, I'm not sure exactly how tall he is. I think he's 6'3", but I'm not sure. But he's anyway 270 to 300 pounds, so fat. But the main thing is the baldness. And he's bald at like a young age, like 18 or 19, maybe only 20, I don't know, but young. Young to be bald. And women don't like, women really do have a thing with hair. And now he's shown pictures of himself, and I actually think of like when he was at his worst, and I actually think he looks okay. But the being bald thing is definitely a problem. Like if you're in college, that's going to be, I mean, it's a problem anytime, but it's a super problem in college. So he being like, I guess, some type of social retard or just a typical guy, like is unable to pick up the cues from her that she's just not interested. Or he does pick them up and just keeps doing it. So he mentions 5 different times where he tries to start a conversation with her, and he gets shut down each time. He also said something interesting, which is that one time he asked her a question, and he said, I have kind of a deep, distinct voice, so I know she heard me. And she just kept walking without saying anything. He said, and this is what happened. This is how people treat you when you're unattractive. Now, this one is interesting to me because I have had that happen to me. There's at least 2 occasions where girls have done that one to me. But here's my problem with it. That doesn't mean, now, yes, could that mean that the girl's disgusted by you? Yeah, it could have. The thing is, my brother's had, like, a lot of success with, I mean, he's married now, it's too late, but, like, when he was younger, had a lot of success with girls. He had, like, and including some pretty attractive ones, and I know it's happened to him, too. So it doesn't mean that they're disgusted by you, per se. It means they're not interested, and they're just like, I'm not dealing with it right now, especially since women are kind of like moody and just fickle, I guess you could say, by nature. Like, you just got them at a bad time or whatever. It really doesn't mean anything. It does not mean they're disgusted by you. They're not trying to deliberately hurt you. They're just not, do they consider you beneath them? Yes, but that's just what. But this gets back to another thing that I think is really important. With the exception of places like Afghanistan, where they really do just seem to, like, hate women, there is nothing that society values more than an attractive young woman. Like, attractive young women are, like, at the pinnacle of society. They have the peak of status. So they get treated a way that it's almost inevitable that they start to see people, like, beneath them, especially when they're fending off unwanted advances all the time. So I'm not saying this is ever an excuse for rudeness, but I'm saying that if you understand where they're coming from, maybe you don't have to take it so personally. I would say, though, it bothered me hearing him say that, like, after the first time he got shut down, he continued to try. Like, because he said, okay, well, now I know that I just wasn't attractive enough for her. It's like, well, whether you're attractive enough for her or not, you shouldn't have even had to know that. Like, let's say that you actually looks mogged her or whatever. All you need is that one clear indication she's not interested for you to stop bothering her. And, you know, like, I don't understand, like, why that's so difficult for some guys. Like, okay, dude, she's not feeling it. Leave her the fuck alone. And most of the things he was saying about her, like, because you can tell this bothered him. It stuck with him for 9 years, apparently. But she did, like it wasn't that bad. Like, so he tried to talk to her, and she shut him down. It happens to guys everywhere, all over the world, every day. And some of them aren't even bad-looking guys. It's just life. She wasn't feeling it, man. And but anyway, the stories he tells, like, about her shutting him down, they're not that bad. It's just, like, typical stuff. It's just the way that girls act when it's nothing to do with him being ugly, per se. It has to do with they don't want, they're not interested. And they're trying to make sure that, you know, they're putting up their shield so you don't bother them. Because if they were nice, yeah, I'm sorry, but there's a lot of guys who would interpret that as interest. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I would interpret that as interest. So so that's as deep as it goes. But anyway, whatever. You know, if you're hurt, you're hurt. It's not his fault he was hurt. And so whatever. That's the end of the class ends, and he doesn't see her again for years, apparently. So 9 years later, 9 years, two hair transplants, and 80 pounds of weight loss later, he's looking a lot better. He's also grown out some facial hair, which has, you know, with the low body fat, it sounds like he's a bigger guy, and he's contouring the facial hair. Facial hair is the closest thing that men have to makeup, you know, and if you do it right and you have the right facial, like, I mean, Casey's facial hair is just horrible. He's got to shave that shit. It looks horrible. But the right face and the right facial hair quality, it can look okay. So this is a guy who really has, he's really looks maxed. And he's the type of guy who's benefited from looks maxing. Another thing is, he never mentions this, but this girl, so this story took place when they were 19. I mean, the first part of the story took place when they were 19. So he matches her on Bumble 9 years later. Well, guess what? His SMV's gone up. Hers has gone down. Now, I'm not saying that men age like fine wine. I'm not saying that type of shit at all. Like, even a really good-looking 28-year-old is going to be too old for a lot of girls, you know, who are 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. By the time you're 24, you're probably not going to be too old for any 28's not going to be too old for any 24-year-old girl. But, that, like, so I'm not trying to say that, like, any type of, like, men's SMV goes up. Or, I mean, men decline just as badly with age as women do. But they're in an absolute sense, or in an objective sense, but not in an SMV sense. And so his SMV has gone way up, and I'm not saying her SMV is in the toilet or anything, but the SMV of like a fit, attractive, white 19-year-old girl, that's like in the stratosphere. A fit, attractive 28-year-old white girl, still high, but it's nothing like a 19-year-old. So another thing is, it's been 9 years. Maybe she's changed a little bit. I mean, people, like, she was 19. 19 is just a kid. She's probably changed and grown up a little bit. So anyway, he likes her on Bumble. Bumble apparently is that kind of app. And I'm pretty sure I knew this. I know I knew this. But he mentions it in the story that, like, I don't know why they do this, but the girl has to message first. And I'm not sure what the point of that is, because girls don't like to do that. And when they do, one criticism I've heard of guys who've been on Bumble is that when they do message first, they just say something like, hey, or something like that. But anyway, she messages first, like, really enthusiastically, like, hey. And so he's talking to her over text, getting great, super enthusiastic response. But he's saying, it feels wrong, you know, that I'm talking to this girl who treated me, who was so disinterested and treated me so rudely. It's like, she wasn't rude. Or if she was rude, she was only as rude as she needed to be. Also, if she was being rude, how rude is it for you to have kept trying to hit on her when, you know, when she had clearly shown non-interest? I mean, okay, the first time is one thing, but honestly, I'm not even sure she's being rude after the first time. You know, I think you're the one who's being rude. And she's, you know, like, by continuing to hit on her when she shows she's not interested. Like, I hope that she taught you a lesson to not continue to hit on girls who are clearly not interested. So, like, new posters thing about it. New posters saying this guy just doesn't understand that, you know, you've got to be looks matched when you're going after girls and stuff like that. He thinks that, like, he's entitled to get attention from, like, attractive girls, you know, even when he's, you know, his SMV is well below him. And that's not really how I interpreted it. I interpreted it more as, like, this guy just doesn't understand that, like, it's rude to hit on girls who aren't attracted to you. It doesn't, like I said, it doesn't matter if, you know, she was out of his league or not. Like, let's say that she wasn't out of his league. Like, then it's okay. Then it would be okay for her to be rude, but not if they're in the same league. No, the thing is, for whatever reason, she's not interested. It doesn't matter why. Stop fucking bothering her. But anyway, so I would have said, like, dude, if that's the way it feels and it bothers you that much, then don't fucking go out with her. But he's kind of like, he doesn't really know. It sounds like he doesn't really know how he feels. Like he still thinks she's kind of cute. And I think there was definitely part of him that wanted to get back at her. Part of him wanted to not so much even get back at her, but it's kind of like a redemption for himself to like prove to himself, like, look how far I've come. Part of it was just because, well, she was cute, you know, whatever. And, but he still obviously has some resentment. I don't think it's like murderous resentment. And again, it's not his fault if he feels resentment. It's just that logically the resentment makes no sense. And he doesn't seem to understand that. And so he goes, has a date with her. During the date, he, you know, makes a clue, said like, look, we were in the same class together in freshman year. We had this elective and we sat next to each other. And he says that she's just like in disbelief. And so I don't know if, I mean, I wasn't there. Like, I don't know if her mind really was blown or not, if he's remembering it wrong. Neither would, I'm going to just assume it happened the way he said, but maybe she wasn't really in shock. Who knows? Because sometimes girls will act shocked when they're not. So I don't know. So anyway, she basically invites him back to her place or whatever. And what follows is, like, it's weird because it's not graphic at all, but it's, like, really unpleasant to listen to, like, him explain, like, about how he ended up sleeping with her. Like, just something about it. Like, I think when it comes to telling stories, you either have it or you don't. And, like, DBDR, whether you like him or not, he has it. And I like Chad Light's content. I think he has it in terms of content creation. I don't think he's much of a storyteller. And there's nothing wrong with the way he tells the stories. He's very, like, he doesn't do, like, the and stuff that I always do. But, like, he's just not really able to tell stories in an entertaining fashion. I don't know why. And, like, especially when he was saying, like, telling the story about, like, how, you know, it ended up, like, getting, you know, to the bedroom or whatever you want to say. I know that's kind of tough to do because it's not really, like, nobody wants to hear that shit. But, I thought it was bad. I thought it was bad. It was kind of like, can we get this over with? And again, there was nothing wrong with it. There was nothing graphic or anything. It was just like, you know, I don't know. It just didn't work. Didn't work for me. That could just be like, you know, he might not be objectively bad at it. It could just be that, you know, it doesn't do it for me. But I mean, you know, maybe I'm the one who's fucked up, or maybe neither of us are. I don't know. But anyway, So anyway, they go to her place. They're like watching a movie or something, and it's something like Elton John movie, I guess, that had been back from like 2011 or 2012. I'm not familiar with it at all. I don't know if it's like some Elton John biopic or what, but it sounds really stupid. And he said, "Oh, it's a great movie." So that makes me think, like, again, I don't know too much about Chad Light, but I'm starting to think like he's like one of those like half normies, half online people, because like a lot of the stuff he says is like very normie-ish, like stuff that normies say. And my guess is his taste in pop culture is extremely normie-ish, because I haven't seen this movie, but I'm sure that it sucks. And I don't even know what movie he's talking about. But if it's like something about Elton John, then the movie, I mean, of course the movie sucked. Like, I mean, I don't have to see it. I don't even have to see the previews. And he, like, the fact for him to, like, go out of his way to mention it was a great movie is weird. So anyway, he says during, like, the movie, they start holding hands, like, which is, I guess, I mean, kind of, like, cringe, I guess. But that's, you know, that's what, I mean, one night stands kind of are always going to be cringe. Like, unless you're, like, some super, like, Lothario or Casanova or something. There's no way to do it and not to be awkward. And then, but anyway, sounds like she's down the whole way. She's kind of leading this thing the whole way, takes it to the bedroom. You know, he takes, you know, finishes the job. They go to sleep. He wakes up sometime in the middle of the night. And then he leaves and ghosts her. Like, she tries to contact him the next day and he doesn't reply. Not very nice, but, like, new poster said, like, you know, he's just being a dick trying to get back at her. I don't think that was it. I really don't think that was it. I think he was genuinely uncomfortable with this whole situation. And, you know, maybe he shouldn't have been, but again, it's not his fault if he felt uncomfortable about it. And I think that it was something like he had spent a night with her or whatever and been talking to her. When I say spend a night, I don't mean like that night in bed. I meant like he had had that date with her. And he knew that, you know, from time talking with her and from this wasn't somebody he wanted to continue to be involved with. Maybe some of it's related to ex-bitterness. Maybe they just didn't click. I don't know. And, but for whatever reason, he didn't want to, like, ghosting her, not nice, shouldn't have done it. That's, you know, I would prefer, obviously, he had at least said, like, yeah, you know, I don't know if this is, like, a long-term thing for us. But on the other hand, like, ghosting might actually be easier. I mean, like, I feel like kind of, like, part of being a man is just settling it. I'm gonna be honest, like, if it was, like, a girl to me, I would rather have her ghost me than actually tell me, like, just, like, no, you know, like, I'm not feeling it, I don't want to see you again. But, you know, for me, I would rather just do the courtesy, even if it's not what she wanted, of telling her, like, look, I don't think this is something I want to do again, just because I feel like that's what you're supposed to do. But I also know that this is something this girl seemed to genuinely give him anxiety. So if anybody's going to get a pass for ghosting, I think it should be Chad Light in this situation. I don't think what he did, because there was no malicious intent, I don't think, or lack of consideration. I think it was just something like he felt uncomfortable about the whole thing. He didn't think they were a good fit, and that was that. I don't think there's anything super wrong with it. Plus, ghosting is, like, so socially acceptable now. Yeah, was there anything else? Yeah, I mean, I didn't actually see the absolute end of the video. This has to do with, again, him not being the world's greatest storyteller. And I kind of, like I said, I wanted to come and make this video. So I got to the part with him ghosting her, and then I just stopped listening. So I don't know if there was, like, some extra part at the end that I missed, because there was, like, a minute or a minute and a half left. But, no, I thought it was, overall, though, an interesting story. I kind of wonder if, like, she ends up seeing the video, because the YouTube algorithm's pretty good. Like, if the YouTube algorithm somehow figures it out and sends her the story, like, I wonder what she would think about it. Yep, that's all for now, and I'll see you in the next.